All right, good morning, everybody. It is Dr. Greenbeard here, and I just wanted to take a minute to do a daily dose. So, you know, you see I got the clone and started to shell stuff up here, but I want to give you a Dr. Greenbeard pro tip, and at the same time, I want to open and start a discussion, all right, about the stems and stalks, because in the last, probably about the last 10 days, I've noticed a lot of people here in Las Vegas have harvested plants. And then they're showing like the stalks and everything, and everybody's showing these hollow stalks. And if you go into a lot of the forums and stuff out there, and some of the, I'll say there's less scientific knowledge available. If you go into like Roll It Up or, you know, Farmer, whatever it's called, blah, 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 people say, oh, you know, I have hollow stems, hollow stalks. It's great. It's wonderful. And the truth is, we can debate, but having been a person who used to grow in Vegas, that I began to realize things. Why did my stems, why were they more hollow in the summer? Why did my plants seem to look bigger, but when they dried up from the hollow stems, shriveled to nothing? So I did some research, and here's what I found. Believe it or not, the cannabis plant, sometimes, rarely, but sometimes, especially in warm temperatures, low humidity environments with poor air circulation, and specifically, areas of the western United States where the soil is bad or maybe a little bit more acidic, okay? The boron deficiency also affects calcium uptake, so that would explain your yellowing, your necrotic spots. A lot of people confuse it for nitrogen or calcium deficiency, but it's not. Your stems and your stalks, when you cut them down, should be solid. They should be solid, okay? They shouldn't be hollow. And the reason I've come to this conclusion, and I'd like to debate it, is for this reason. When I had hollow stems, someone told me, hey, rather than argue with me and say that your buds are healthy, why don't you do this? Why don't you treat the plants with the hollow stems as if they had a boron deficiency that was affecting calcium uptake? And I thought, okay, that seems like a fair request. Why not? And then the next thing I was told was, hey, get your temperature under control. Get that straight. Get your airflow right. And here's what I found. The second I got my temperature dialed in, the second I got my airflow figured out, all of my plants started to get these real sturdy stalks, real solid stalks. All right? My plants started to not only have those stalks, but what used to be a certain amount during harvest would become something else. In other words, I literally noticed about a 35% increase in my harvest weight the second I started thinking that, oh, this isn't healthy and cool. This could be something else. So in my research, I found that hollow stems and stalks on a cannabis plant, especially if you're growing indoors in Las Vegas, I can almost guarantee you are dealing with a boron deficiency, and it's affecting your calcium and magnesium. And I know that because boron's immobile. And when I see the pictures of these plants, I see the new growth is what's effective. And that's what that means. So if your upper limbs are starting to show some yellowing, like the newer growth is yellowing, all right, that's not healthy. That's not your plant finishing. That's not it's ready and it's almost done. That's your plant's roots are almost done. And they're about to start going downhill fast. I promise, I wouldn't lie to you, but this doesn't always apply. Like I said, this is mainly something that we found in the western United States, people growing indoors, high temperatures, low humidity. Hence the reason your stalks aren't like that in November, in October. All right, guys? So I just wanted to put this out there for discussion, especially here in Vegas. Here's what I would tell you to do. If your stems are hollow, the next time you do a newt change, give them fresh water, 420 mark. Give them fresh, clean water. And then try this. Put a spoon of borax, a teaspoon of borax for every gallon in your reservoir. So if you have a 40-gallon reservoir, you could put 40 teaspoons of borax in there. Now, I wouldn't put that much. Truth is, 40-gallon reservoir, I put 10 teaspoons of borax in there. And I'm almost willing to bet that if you do that, magical things will happen. And I'm going to tell you this right now. There's some over-the-counter things that people overlook. Borax, Epsom salt, hello magnesium people. just know this, calcium, magnesium, boron, everything that like really makes the plant look lush and green and beautiful, the nitrogen, all of those work together. And I would encourage, especially people in southwestern United States that are growing indoors where it's a little warmer, I'm almost willing to bet that if you were to cool those temperatures down and treat a boron deficiency, magical things will happen. You think your harvests are beautiful and wonderful now, just try my theory just once. Treat it as if you had a boron deficiency that was affecting calcium uptake and watch magic happen. All right, everybody, I just wanted to make this quick video because, you know, I've seen situations where people get massive harvests on hollow stems, but the truth is most people don't want to admit it. They have those hollow stems, and when they go to dry and cure their buds, they end up with the nickel fritz, the snickle fritz, or doo-wop, or whatever you want to call it. So go ahead, try me out. If I'm wrong and it doesn't apply to you, so be it. But I can tell you this right now, everybody in the Growficial Bucket Drip System that started getting those hollow stems, we handled airflow, handled temperature, we handled boron. As soon as we did that, boom! And it'll do the same for you, I'm willing to bet. If not, what have you lost? Nothing. Try it once and see what happens. I bet you come find me and hug me. All right, everybody, we'll talk to you tomorrow. Peace.